Hello grade 7. In this video, you will learn how to square a trinomial. So ano po kapag sinabing square of trinomial? So ang keyword po natin dito ay square and trinomial. So trinomial means a polynomial with three terms. Okay? So pag sinabi nating square of trinomial, so let's say we have the trinomial a plus b plus c. So, pag sinabing square of this trinomial, imumultiply lang po natin yung a plus b plus c sa sarili niya, which is a plus b plus c also. Okay? So, that's how we square an expression. We multiply it by itself. So, sabi ko nga, let us represent every trinomial using this trinomial a plus b plus c. So, remember, a represents every first terms, and then b represents the second terms, and then c represents the third terms. Okay? So, let us try to derive the pattern that we are going to use using the distributive property. So, dun muna tayo sa long method. Okay? So, gamitin natin yung long method para ma-derive natin yung shortcut. Okay? So, let us now distribute starting with the first term, which is a. So, a times a is a squared. A times b is positive ab, and then positive a times positive c is positive ac. So, next naman ay kay b. So, let's multiply positive b times positive a. So, we have positive ab, and then positive b times positive b. So, that is positive b squared, positive b times positive c, so that is positive bc. Next is the last term, which is c. So c, positive c times positive a is positive ac. Positive c times positive b is positive bc. And then positive c times positive c is positive c squared. So now let us try to arrange the terms. Because as you can see, meron po tayong mga similar terms dito. Okay? So, let us underline the similar terms. We have AB and another AB here. So, meron na tayong first group or first pair. So, we have here AC and another AC here. And we have BC and another BC here. So, as you can see, three pairs yan ng similar terms. So, arranging the terms and writing them in decreasing order and also alphabetical na rin. So, we can rewrite the expression as a squared plus b squared plus c squared plus ab plus ab plus bc plus bc plus ac plus ac. Okay? And then, of course, we have to combine the like terms, okay, for us to obtain the simplified expression. So, sabi ko nga po ha, mas maganda na po na sundin natin yung alphabetical order para mas uniform yung magiging sagot natin. Okay? Pero when it comes to degree naman, so as you can see, equal naman yung degree nila. Okay? Pare-parehas naman niya na 2. So, pag ganyan po na equal naman yung degree, so magbase na lang po tayo sa alphabetical order. So, let's now combine the similar terms. So, pag kinombine natin tong AB plus AB, so that's 1AB plus 1AB, we have 2AB. And then, 1BC plus 1BC is of course 2BC. And then, 1AC plus 1AC is 2AC. Therefore, the simplified form is A squared plus B squared plus C squared plus 2AB plus 2BC plus 2AC. Remember, sabi ko dun sa umpisa, di ba? A represents the first term, B represents the second term, C represents the third term. So, when we are squaring a trinomial, interpret po natin yung lumabas na sagot. Ang una muna natin gagawin is, i-square natin yung tatlong terms. So, ang first term ay yung square. Yung first term ng product is the square of the first term of the trinomial. Okay? So, that's a squared. And then, yung second term is the square of the second term of the trinomial. So, that's b squared. And then, yung third term is the square of c. Kaya po, c squared. Okay? And then, next po, yung third, fourth, and yung fourth, fifth, and sixth terms naman ay ma-obtain natin by multiplying each pair. And then, multiplying the product by 2. Okay? So, pagpapartnerin muna natin yung A at B. A times B, and then times 2. Kaya 2AB. And then, B times C times 2. Kaya 2BC. And then, A times C times 2. Kaya 2AC. So, tatandaan po natin yun na first and second. And then, second and third. And then, first and third. So, dapat po silang tatlo ay magkaka partner. Okay? So, ang ma-obtain po nating polynomial po ay mayroong 6 terms. Okay? So, posible naman po yung magbago. Depende po sa given. But, initially, we are going to get or obtain a 6-term polynomial when we square a trinomial. So, let's have here an example. So, what is the square of 2x plus y minus 3z? Okay? So, sabi ko nga po, kapag nag-i-square tayo, we multiply the expression by itself. So, try muna natin gamitin yung long method. And then, later on, we are going to compare it with the pattern that we obtained. So, using the distributive property, so let us first distribute 2x. 2x times 2x is 4x squared. 2x times positive y is positive 2xy. 2x times negative 3z, so take note of this, negative po dahil minus yung nasa unahan. Okay, so 2x times negative 3z is negative 6xz. Okay, and then next po, positive y naman po tayo. So, positive y times 2x is positive 2xy. Positive y times positive y is positive y squared. And then, positive y times negative 3z is negative 3yz. So, lastly, we have negative 3z. Negative 3z times 2x is, so negative times positive, kaya magiging negative 6xz. So, take note ha, lagi siyang papareho dun sa isa. Okay, lagi silang parehas. And then next, negative 3z times positive y. So, we have now negative 3yz. So, parehas naman siya dito sa isa. And then lastly, we have negative 3z times negative 3z. So, that is negative times negative magiging positive na po. So, that's positive 9z squared. So, nakuha na po natin yung lahat ng terms. So, i-arrange po ulit natin siya or i-rewrite natin in alphabetical and standard form or decreasing order. So, we will get 4x squared and then plus y squared and then plus 9z squared plus 2xy plus 2xy. So, lagi pong dalawang magkaparehas. And then minus 3yz minus 3yz. And then minus 6xz minus 6xz. And then combining the like terms, we will obtain 4x squared plus y squared plus 9z squared plus 4xy dahil positive 2 plus positive 2. And then minus 6yz, so dahil po yan ay negative 3 plus negative 3. And then minus 12xz. So dahil po negative 6 plus negative 6, kaya naging negative 12. So yan na po ang ating final answer dahil wala na naman pong kailangang i-combine. Okay? And then siya ay naka-standard form na din. So let's try naman na gamitin yung pattern. So let us now try to apply the square of trinomial pattern for us to square the trinomial 2x plus y minus 3z. So tatandaan po ha, ito ang ating pattern. So I want you to remember that the first three terms are just the squares of the terms of the trinomial. So we have a squared plus b squared plus c squared. At dahil po sila ay square nung mga terms ng trinomial, they are always positive. So, kahit po anong expression kapag in-square natin, laging positive ang sagot. Because, positive times positive is positive and negative times negative is still positive. Okay? So, that's why yung first three terms, lagi po yung positive. So, yung fourth, fifth, and sixth term ay depende naman po dun sa sign ng mga terms ng trinomial. Basta ang tatandaan, so it's always twice the product of every two terms. So, pagpa-partner-partnerin nyo yung tatlo, so magsimula ka muna dun sa first at second, kay A at B, kaya 2AB. And then next naman ay yung second at third, kaya plus 2BC. And then yung huli ay yung first at yung third, kaya plus 2AC. So, pwede naman magkabaliktad tong tatlo. Okay, pwedeng magkapalit-palit. So, wag lang may mawawalang isa. So, anim na terms po ang makukuha natin bago tayo mag-simplify. So, try natin pong i-apply para ma-solve natin yung square ng 2x plus y minus 3z. Ayan. So, sinubstitute na po natin. So, saan po nang galing yan? Tandaan, sa ating trinomial, ang a po ay yung 2x. So, dahil siya yung first term, ang B po natin dyan ay yung Y, this one. And then, ang C po natin ay yung negative 3Z. So, negative po dahil minus yung nasa unahan. Okay? So, yan po ha. We have A as 2X, B as Y, and then C as negative 3Z. So, ipa-plug in lang natin siya dun sa pattern. So, ang first term ay A squared, meaning the square of 2x. Okay? And then, ang second term ay b squared. So, square naman natin yung y. Kaya, y squared. And then, third term, c squared. So, i-square naman natin yung negative 3z. Okay? And then, plus 2ab. So, 2 times the first term, kaya 2x, times the second term, kaya po times y. So, 2 times 2x times y. And then next, plus 2bc naman. So, 2 times the second times the third. So, that's 2 times y times negative 3z. And then lastly, we have plus 2ac. So, 2 times the first times the third. So, 2 times 2x times negative 3z. Okay? Ayan. So, ganyan po natin ipa-plug in yung values sa ating pattern. So, next naman is isi-simplify natin. Simplifying this expression, we will get this one. So, explain po natin kung saan nanggaling ang bawat term ha. So, 4x squared ay nanggaling po dito sa square of 2x. Dahil yan po ay 2x times 2x. Okay? So, 2 times 2, 4, x times x, x squared. So, applying the power of a product rule, so, didistribute lang natin yung exponent dun sa mga factors na nasa loob. Kaya siya ay 2 squared x squared, and 2 squared is 4. Next, so, y squared. So, the square of y is simply y squared. So, positive ulit. And then next, the square of negative 3z. So, distribute lang natin, magiging negative 3 squared z squared. And negative 3 squared is negative 3 times negative 3. So, that is positive 9. Okay, kaya siya ay naging plus 9z squared. And the next, 2 times positive 2x is positive 4x. And then positive 4x times y is positive 4xy. The next, positive 2 times positive y is positive 2y. And then positive 2y times negative 3z. So positive times negative, kaya po naging minus 6yz. Okay? So i-multiply nyo na lang yung positive 2 at negative 3. So positive 2 times negative 3 is negative 6. And then copy nyo na lang yung yz. Okay? So yz. And then lastly, ganun din. So, i-multiply nyo na lang muna yung mga numbers. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times negative 3 is negative 12. So, negative 12. And then, just copy the variables x and z. So, x, z. Okay? So, yan na po yung ating final answer. So, let's try the following. Okay. So, let us try another example here. What is the square of a plus 3b plus 2c? Let us first identify a, b, and c, o yung first, second, at yung third term. So again, this is our pattern. So the first term is still a. A pa din naman po siya. The second term is 3b. And the third term is 2c. Okay, so ito yung ipa-plug in natin sa pattern po natin, okay? So, first term, a squared, that means a pa din siya, a squared. Then, second term ay b squared. So, plus, ang b natin ay 3b. Ayan, and then ang third term ay c squared, ang c natin ay 2c. So, magiging square of 2c. And then, ang fourth term ay 2ab. So, 2 times the first times the second. So, we have 2 times a times 3b. And the next, 2 times the second times the third naman. So, 2 times 3b times 2c. And then lastly ay 2 times the first times the third. So that's 2 times A times 2C. Ayan. And then next is we simplify the expression. So the square of A, of course, is A squared. A times A. And then what is the square of 3B? So distribute natin yung 2, magiging 3 squared b squared. So, 3 squared is 9. And then, b squared is b squared. And then, the square of 2c. So, pag dinistribute natin yung 2, magiging 2 squared c squared. And 2 squared is equal to 4. Kaya, magiging 4c squared na po. Okay? So, next, we have, so, dahil positive 2, times positive 3 is 6, kaya magiging plus 6, okay? And then, copy na lang natin yung A at yung B. So, A times B is AB. Next, so we have positive 2 times positive 3, positive 6 po yun. So, positive 6 times positive 2 is positive 12. So, magiging plus 12, and then just copy B and C. So, BC. And then lastly, we have positive 2 times 2. That is positive 4. And then just copy A and C. So, A times C is A, C. Okay? Ayan. So, yan na po yung ating magiging final answer. So, tama yung ating sagot. We have A squared plus 9B squared plus 4C squared plus 6AB plus 12BC plus 4AC. So, next example pa. So, what is the square of 2x minus 3y plus 4? So, ang pattern ulit natin ay ito. So, identify natin yung first, second, and third terms. So, Ang first term natin ay 2x. Ang second term natin ay, so negative po siya dahil minus yung nasa unahan. Negative 3y. And then, ang last term natin ay positive 4. So, 4 na lang. Ayan. So, plug in natin sa ating pattern. So, first term ay a squared. So, yung square ng first term natin, that is 2x. Ayan. So, the square of 2x plus the square of the second term. So, negative 3y squared. And then next, the square of the third term. So, that's 4 squared. Next, the fourth term naman po tayo, we have 2 times a times b. So, that will become 2 times 2x times negative 3y. Okay? So, ito yung a, ito yung b. Next, plus 2bc. So, plus 2 times b natin ay negative 3y. And then, c ay positive 4. And then, lastly, 2ac. So, 2 times ang a ay 2x. And then, ang c ay positive 4. Ayan. So, simplify na po natin yung expression. So, dun muna tayo sa first term. What is the square of 2x? Again, distribute the exponent. That is 2 squared x squared. And 2 squared is 4. Kaya magiging 4x squared. Next, we have negative 3 squared y squared. So, negative 3 squared is negative 3 times negative 3. And that is positive 9. So, y squared, kukopyahin na lang. Okay? So, again, negative times negative is positive. Kaya po positive 9 yan. Next, square of 4. So, 4 times 4 is 16. So, wala pong variable na kasama. Kaya, syempre, wala rin variable pong kasama yung product. Next, so, i-multiply muna natin yung mga coefficients. 2 times 2 is positive 4. Positive 4 times negative 3 is negative 12. So, minus 12. And then, x times y, kaya xy. Next, positive 2 times negative 3 is negative 6. Okay? So, negative 6 times positive 4 is negative 24. And then y. So, wala namang ibang variable, kaya copy y. Then lastly, 2 times 2 is 4, and then 4 times 4 is 16. So, plus 16, and then just copy x dahil wala namang ibang variable. Ayan. So, now, arranging the terms. So, of course, we have to arrange the terms in standard form. Meron tayo ditong constant, at ang constant po ay 0 ang degree. Kaya, dapat siya ay nasa dulo. Okay? So, pag ililipat lang naman po natin yung positive 16. So, pag nilipat natin, ang magiging sagot ay ayan. So, we have 4x squared plus 9y squared minus 12xy plus 16x minus 24y plus 16. So, kung mapapansin nyo, nagbaliktad po yung 16x at yung negative 24y kasi sinunod po natin yung alphabetical order. Okay? So, ang degree po ng first term ay 2, ang degree nito ay 2, ang degree nito ay 2 also kasi the exponent of x is 1, the exponent of y is 1, 1 plus 1 is 2. Okay? So, puro to po yung first three terms. And then, ito po ay, ang degree ay 1. And then, ang degree nito ay 1. So, sinunod lang natin yung alphabetical, kaya nauna yung x. Then, lastly, ito, ang degree po nito ay 0. Kaya siya ang nasa dulo. So, yan po yung final answer natin, okay? So, dapat po ay laging naka-standard form at alphabetical po yung ating terms. So, that's all. So, sana po ay naintindihan po ang square of trinomial.